Well, great images of tonight's game brought to you by Buffalo Wild Wings. Lenzell Smith Jr. going in. But one of the nice stories about tonight, at least for Ohio State, is the play of Aaron Kraft. Back in the first half, it was a 24-17 Arizona lead, 9.5 to play, Lenny, in the first half. He goes out with two fouls. He comes back in, and since he's been back in, they've gone on a 28-9 run, and it's made all the difference. Now, he just picked up his third personal foul moments ago for the Buckeyes.
But it's all about floor leadership. He comes back on, directs the team to get higher percentage shots on the point of the ball, defensively helps create turnovers. You know, one turnover in the last 18 or so minutes has given them extra opportunities for the basket and helped them, even though they're not shooting all that well, help them to push out the lead.
Lions had it knocked away by Ravenel. Also, Deshaun Thomas got in there. Lions hits the deck hard, the senior from Schenectady, New York.
Well, you talked about Kraft and that floor generalship right here. It's been all about the drives of the Ohio State. The big man Amir Williams, who I thought played fantastic the start of this second half. But you talked all about Aaron Kraft. To me, Smith Jr. and his ability to get to the hoop has been huge in this second half as well.
Ravenel just picked up his third personal foul. At the free throw line, Mark Lyons, an 85% free throw shooter, first team all Pac-12 selection. His first point, Lenny, in almost 20 minutes of this game.
Yeah, he's been on lockdown. There's no question about it. Not allowing him to turn a corner, you know, forcing him into some bad decisions as Ohio State defense is really focused on Mark Lyons getting the ball out of his hands and forcing him to make mistakes.
Reg Kraft is going to leave. Scott's going to come in for Ohio State.
Interesting minutes now. You have a 7-point lead with your general going to the bench. Again, Shannon Scott has played fantastic all season at that point guard position for the Buckeyes.
Thomas for three. Deshaun Thomas, the Big Ten's leading scorer, has just drained his third three. He's got 19.
And then I don't understand that, especially recognizing that Deshaun Thomas, what does he really want to do is knock down threes. You've got to switch those dribble handoffs.
Solomon Hill trying to pick and poke his way into a very congested lane. He still comes up with two.
Well, that's a good job by Hill, exercising some patience down inside. You know, not giving up the higher percentage look for something way outside beyond the arc.
Smith and Ravenel. Smith inside. Looking to the defensive Grant Jarrett. Nick Johnson is back in. Hill is on the wing. Found an opening and takes it in.
Solomon Hill offensively trying to put the Wildcats on his shoulders. Doesn't settle for the three-point shot. The little brush screen there by Nick Johnson allows Hill to get into the paint. Ravenel swipes late. Gets contact, picks up his fourth foul. Hill going to the line, trying to go on a personal 5-0 run himself, Lynn.
If you're the back line of Ohio State, you got to move your feet. Everybody's swatting and swishing.
Doing what?
Swatting, swishing, doing whatever it is.
Nice.
They've got to be able to move their feet. You always play defense with your feet. It's about position.
And now the Wildcat faithful coming to their feet.
It's Scott. With just under 10 to play in the second half here from Los Angeles, Ohio State has been to four consecutive Sweet 16s. Sean Miller and his Wildcats making their third trip to the Sweet 16 in the last five. Lyons picks up his second personal foul, and Scott will be at the line for the Buckeyes.
And for all the issues Arizona's had in taking care of the ball, last two possessions, you know, they've gotten 5 points. They're right back within striking distance, even if Shannon Scott makes these free throws.
Here's Scott. He was the former Atlanta High School Player of the Year in Georgia, Georgia High School Basketball Player of the Year. And Reg, you know about his dad, Charlie Scott, played at North Carolina and in the pros.
One of the all-time great Tar Heel players out of the North Carolina lineage of great players to play for the great Dean Smith.
Charlie Scott was the first African-American player to be recruited by Dean Smith to North Carolina.
He certainly was, which is a tribute to Dean Smith, recognizing that the game was changing and also opportunities were necessary.
Arizona with one timeout left. They've called three already this half.
Well, they've been trying to stop the bleeding here, and so far they've done a good job. Now they're trying to get Hill, who scored the last 5 points for the Wildcats. Another look at the basket.
Sweet fadeaway there.
Well, right now, 9 points, or 8 points in the paint. And he's done a terrific job, Solomon Hill.
He's got 14.
Yep.
So nice, we've said it twice. Scott. A little mismatch there. Now they got Lyons back on him. Lenzel Smith on top. Deshaun Thomas has a mismatch against Nick Johnson.
Smart move here if you're Thomas.
Now take it inside. Looks like the foul on Grant Jarrett as he was lunging in and trying to defend. Johnson just picked up his third. Hey, don't miss out on NCAA tournament gear, including Sweet 16 shirts at the official store of the NCAA. Get your gear now at ncaa.com/shop. Here is Deshaun Thomas, who is the top free throw shooter in the Big Ten at 84%.
Way to jinx him, Kev.
Sorry.
Hey, Lynn, did you think that Grant Jarrett rotated a little bit late over there? Because I didn't see there was a lot of contact up top. Maybe there was contact down low on Thomas to send him to the free throw line.
Well, I think certainly with the foul,
yeah,
that somebody committed the foul, but I think he got there right on time. And I think Deshaun Thomas probably could have taken a little more time, located the defense, and found an open man, but he's the guy right now Ohio State's counting on for points.
Thomas now at 20.
It's like they're trying to get the ball to Hill down low with Sam Thompson guarding him.
LaQuinton Ross picks up the foul, number one on him. The winner here, of course, will advance and take on the winner of Wichita State and LaSalle, the Explorers and the Shockers. Up next, here from Los Angeles.
Speed and quickness of LaSalle versus the rebounding of Wichita State.
Hill with a point.
Oh, my goodness. Starting to come alive, starting to feel it.
He's got the last 9 for the Wildcats, who are making a move. They're down by 4.
And the thing about it is, he's getting them in a variety of ways. He's knocking down shots, fadeaways, taking the ball all the way to the cup and finishing.
Scott with the scoop. It's collected. And here comes Arizona with Pera. He's got 5 rebounds. Kraft is setting to come back in. Pera right by Scott. Drew Ross, Lenzel Smith grabs it, 7th rebound.
Here, Solomon Hill, you've got to come get the basketball.
Oh, knocked away by Johnson.
Yeah, but that was a good block by Johnson, but a terrible foul on Parham.
Fast and furious this game is getting, and the block is good, the foul, and we got a game.
Back and forth with Ron in Los Angeles tonight. Arizona led in the first half by 11. Ohio State is led by as many as 10. A couple lead changes. You see the score. And plus 5 rebounding for the Buckeyes in this contest. But Reggie, right now, Arizona's on a 9-3 run with Hill scoring all 9 for the Wildcats.
And you look at those 3-point field goals, they're a little misleading. Arizona, they started the game 5 of 7. They've gone 0 of 5 since. They have not made a 3 in almost 16 minutes.
At the free throw line is sophomore LaQuinton Ross from Jackson, Mississippi. Averages about 16 points a game. So he's out there with Lenzel Smith Jr., Deshaun Thomas, Aaron Kraft, and Thompson. That's the Buckeye 5 with under 8 to play in the second half.
And I don't know about you, but if I'm Sean Miller, I'm looking to try to get the ball to number 44, Solomon Hill. Offensively, he's the one Wildcat that has it going.
Johnson off to Mark Lyons. Back to Nick Johnson for 3. Tap in try by Brandon Ashley. Also out there is Grant Jarrett and Solomon Hill. That is the Wildcat 5 on the floor with Ashley picking up his first personal foul.
Well, Reggie, somebody needs to get that memo. Here's a guy with a hot hand
that's
been putting points on the board, and he didn't even get a touch on that last possession.
Free throws now coming up. Ross once again at the free throw line. He is a 73% free throw shooter for the Bucks. They've won 10 consecutive games coming in. One of their games that really kind of spun their season around was a Sunday afternoon against number four, that time number four, Michigan State. And in that game, the Buckeyes, who really hadn't had a quality win, who came in 19-9, beat Tom Izzo and Michigan State. In that game, Aaron Kraft began to really take the ball to the rim, and that kind of spun his season around a little bit more offensively, and they've won 10 games, including that one since.
Yeah, he was losing a lot of confidence in his shot, and once that happened, he started to recognize the opportunities for him, particularly if you're taking the ball inside.
On top, Arizona. Let's go to Lewis Johnson.
And Kevin, you know, back on February 17th, Ohio suffered that big loss to Wisconsin by the score of 49-71, as the foul is called. And it was after that loss that the soul searching began, and Aaron Kraft telling me that they had a team meeting. They really called it a program meeting. And the most important thing they wanted the guys to understand was that the coaches had done a great job of getting them ready to play, that it was on them to get things correct. So the team decided to be more responsible in practices, in the game, and to bring a teammate along. And they've tried to hold each other accountable, and that's what's gotten them here to this point as well.
And you know, Lewis, what Thad said at that time, he says, you know, we've got a bunch of nice guys on this team, Reg, but sometimes he thought he wanted to see more fight. He wanted to see a little bit more grit from the team. And I think that game against the Spartans and onward through the Big Ten tournament, which they won in Chicago, it's been on display.
Look, haven't we always been taught nice guys finish last? And I think finally these guys have looked themselves in the mirror and understand we need to play a little bit more rugged. And what better way when you're going against a Tom Izzo Michigan State team? Because if you're not going to play tough, physical, and a little bit nasty against the Spartans of Michigan State, then you're never going to be ready.
About playing angry, playing like somebody's about to take something from you.
Sean Thomas, who just picked up his second personal foul, has it. We're approaching seven to play in the second half from Los Angeles. The winner to the Elite Eight. Kraft, shot clock at eight. Defended here by Ashley. Reaching in with Hill. That was just enough to knock him off his horse.
Tell you what, great defense there by the freshman, Brandon Ashley. Got caught off on the switch on Aaron Kraft. And that's exactly when you were 6'8", 6'9", and you're guarding a guard at 6'1", 6'2", that doesn't like to take the outside shot. Give him space. Allow him to come to you, and that's exactly what Ashley did.
Although Lenzel Smith Jr. could have cut to the basket once Ashley got off of him and tried to help out.
Trap on Hill. Shot clock at 18, so plenty of time with which to work. Once again, Hill and Lenzel Smith is on him. Little hedge there by Thompson. Outside, Lyons a three.
They needed that so bad. More importantly, Mark Lyons' confidence needed that.
He's got 14 and a couple of threes.
He's been the unofficial closer for the Wildcats this season. Oh, great close down defense there by Arizona.
Ross for three.
We saw a couple of those shots from Ross versus Iowa State in round three.
Ross has 10. He averages 7. Trying to make it go inside is Kevin Parham. He's got 7 points, the senior from the Bronx.
Here's my only thing, Lynn. Does Arizona, and we spoke with Sean Miller talking about the Wildcats getting back to basics defensively. Can they stop anyone? Can they stop this Buckeye team?
Well, I'll tell you, they have the makeup and the matchup to be able to make it difficult to score.
Ash across the lane, he puts it in. He's got 12.
But interestingly enough, that's the one matchup that they're at a disadvantage, with Ross being guarded by Brandon Ashley.
Oh, great moves by Lyons as he takes it inside, and a foul. He gave a move with every part of his body right there. And for all the background on the unique relationships between these teams, but namely Thad Matta and Sean Miller, get Team Stream from Bleacher Report. Thompson just picked up his second personal foul. At the free throw line is Mark Lyons. And Lenny talked about this earlier, the transfer after 3 seasons at Xavier.
Yeah, Mark Lyons played along another combo guard in Two Holloway. And between the two of them, they could put a lot of points on the board, but they were never really suited to play with each other on a consistent basis where they both thrived. One had to be the playmaker, the other had to be the scorer, and vice versa. Holloway became the scorer. And, you know, I think Mark Lyons, after it was all said and done and Holloway left, figured it was time. He had some eligibility left. It was time to kind of part ways with the Xavier program and get one more opportunity here with Arizona.
Right now, Sean Miller imploring his team at the defensive end.
And it was Sean Miller who recruited Mark Lyons. So it's fitting that he finishes here.
Yeah, he understands the system.
Kraft driving on Lyons. No knock count.
But he goes to the free throw line.
LaQuinton Ross has scored the last 9 points for Ohio State.
Well, he's a stretch 3-4 for the Buckeyes, and this is no accident. Averages 8 points for Ohio State off the bench.
Lyons picks up his third. And here's Aaron Kraft, a 77% free throw shooter. Improved from last year to this. And it's the first. How about his parents? The state of Ohio paying for a couple of kids to go to college. You know about Aaron, the junior from Findlay, went to Liberty Benton High School. His younger sister, Kate, is a freshman on the Buckeye basketball team for the women. You saw his parents and her parents, Sean and Wendy. And she, I'm told, is a terrific shooter. No surprise there. Runs in the family. Mom and dad are happy. The Buckeyes on top by 6.
You can choose to take your chances, or you can choose the Infiniti JX, the only luxury crossover in the world that can sense what's behind you even when you can't, and can apply the brakes even before you do. The Infiniti JX, with backup collision intervention system. Lease an Infiniti JX for $489 a month. Infiniti, inspired performance.
Coming up next here in Los Angeles, LaSalle and Wichita State. And we're going to get a load of those two players right there. They're terrific.
Dr. Giannini and his four guard lineup, they put a lot of pressure on most teams. Dribble drive penetration and their ability to knock down the threes.
They're the Explorers warming up. Great story. You know, they won a national championship back in 1954, played again in 1955 when they won in 54. Tom Doyle led the way. Doyle was there in 55, but Bill Russell in San Francisco got him in the national final.
Well, they got him that year, and in the following year, Bill Russell, Casey Jones went on a tremendous streak of unbeaten.
That is a three-point shot. Solomon Hill couples it up and goes back in as the shot was missed inside by Lyons. They tie it up. The defense by the Buckeyes. It is Ohio State's ball.
Wow. I'm not quite sure that basketball wasn't tipped out of the hands of Hill right there. That's not a tie-up in my opinion.
Arizona led by 11 in the first half. Ohio State is led by 10 here in the second. Ohio State is shooting 50% from three and 42% overall.
The ball's in Aaron Kraft's hands for a reason. Create this harmony on the defensive end and finding an open man. That time Ross took it straight to the basket but didn't finish.
Jared had the rebound. Parham and Mark Lyons. Lyons had the 27 against Harvard. Nice screen. Oh, look at the great move inside by Hill and back out to Parham for three. Yeah. Rebound inside. Pulled down by Sam Thompson.
If you're Sean Miller, you cannot have asked for a better possession right there. Hill had collapsed the defense. Four white jerseys around them. Parham had a wide open corner three.
Three and a half to play. 6-point Buckeye lead. Ross!
Gotta make those.
Here on the rebound, Wildcats scratching the other way. Johnson, Hill, Lyons for three. Short, Kraft the rebound. Fouled on the play by Grant Jarrett. 3:16 to play. Jarrett picks up number two.
You
ABC, our game reset here in Los Angeles. Lenny, what'd you think of Arizona's last two possessions?
Well, the first of those two was a drive by Hill, and he ran into a stiff defense under the basket. The kick out was a good three. I like when threes go inside out. But the last shot by Mark Lyons, you got to wonder, okay, what was he thinking at that time? You have an opportunity to run some more plays and move guys without it, force Ohio State to play. And more importantly, Lyons has been saddled with trying to handle the ball, create for others, as well as create his own offense. And you wonder if he has the legs for that shot, because that shot came up pretty short.
Well, you're talking about legs. Remember now, Aaron Kraft has been picking him up and dogging him most of this game. And that's when legs start to become a factor. Remember, Aaron Kraft versus Iowa State was not great down the stretch from the free throw line.
Well, tonight he is 6 of 7. Ohio State is a team for the game, 21 of 24.
And look, Aaron Kraft switched out on Solomon Hill.
Hill. Rebound by Ross, who has played well. His first rebound, he's got the 12 points, and the Bucks the other way.
And it was the fake that got Hill. He did not need to pump fake on the smaller Aaron Kraft. As soon as he got in there, he just should have faded away and shot over the smaller defender.
Yeah, he's a rhythm shooter. Look at his defense.
Nick Johnson, great huddle on the
got a timeout.
That's the last one for Arizona. That's the last timeout.
Well, I'll tell you what, that takes away a lot of options, though, for Sean Miller not having any more timeouts. But how about the hustle by Mr. Do Everything for the Wildcats, Nick Johnson?
Last timeout used by Arizona.
Yeah, and we talked about late game situations for Sean Miller, especially with Ohio State being in the bonus, going to the free throw line. You've got to score on just about every opportunity out here, but you can't stop the clock on made field goals.
Well, here's why when guys come out of the huddle, you got to know which way the arrow's pointing. You know, good hustle by Nick Johnson. Had he just gotten tied up, Sean Miller wouldn't have to burn.
Yeah, but you're thinking about possession and that. Do we have the arrow or not?
You are going to get possession. You did have the arrow.
Jarrett with a three.
Oh, man, what a wide open three. What a great look there.
Parham had the rebound. Nick Johnson. Lyons. Thompson is on him. Kraft is watching Nick Johnson. Swerving in and finding two. And he's got nine.
And usually this is when a coach would call a timeout in a situation like this to set up your full court pressure, but no more timeouts for Arizona.
Well, I'm sure Sean Miller gave the contingencies in the huddle.
Ohio
you know, if we
State
make
is.
It, this is what we do. If we don't make it, this is what we do.
Two timeouts left for Thad Mata in the box.
The solos are complete.
You are the pig to her blankets.
That's not break dancing. That's break up dancing.
Don't give up on us, America. We're not done yet.
Now two must dance as one.
Let's make the night come tonight.
You won't run into the top 10 appliance brands just anywhere.
Yeah.
Only Sears carries them all. This is the top 10 advantage. This is Sears.
1:59 to play. Ohio State leads by four. We're deep in the second half here in Los Angeles.
Well, I'll tell you what, besides utilizing excellent defense to create some separation, Ohio State, when they inbound this ball, they get an opportunity. They've got to work the ball to the point where they're going to make Arizona foul them. You know, they've lived off the foul line. That's helped them create the distance. And right now, Arizona has to come to them.
Well, I'll tell you what, if you're Arizona, you've got to move your feet and try to get a stop without fouling, obviously. Do not want to send the Buckeyes to the free throw line. Switch all these high pick and rolls and make Aaron Kraft beat you from the outside.
Well, there's a double team right there looking to create some problems with the defense.
Ross has got it. Six to shoot on the move.
Oh, my goodness.
Left pick and Ross. 14 points.
Exactly what he needed to do. Take it to the basket. High percentage shot. Force him to play you or let you go.
Ross has 11 of those 14 off here in the second half and a Kraft foul.
How about the hang time for LaQuinton Ross here? You talked about, Lynn, taking the basketball to the hoop. Look at the hang time as the defender, Jarrett, comes over. Just goes right into the body of Jarrett for the reverse.
He actually missed one of those earlier, going straight to the basket, brought it down to his waist, and tried to put a little spin on it.
Still, if you're Sean Miller, you're not in a foul situation. If Lyons makes both of these free throws, you'll only be down 4 points. Still enough time to get a stop and a pretty good look and possession at the other end.
But I'm a little disappointed in Aaron Kraft, because Ohio State definitely not in a position where they needed to foul. They needed Arizona to continue to take time off the clock and try to work their offense instead of giving them an opportunity to put points on the board with no time elapsing.
LaQuinton Ross, who is a sophomore, didn't even play in the NCAA tournament last year. Here he is having a huge impact for the Buckeyes against six-seeded Arizona.
Well, on the floor now, you've got Sam Thompson, who is a 70% free throw shooter, and Smith Jr., who is 68%. Everyone else 75 or above for the Buckeyes.
Thompson looking, Kraft, foul.
Wow.
May have gone on Jordan Mays of Arizona.
And if it wasn't for Aaron Kraft demonstrating some strength on the ball, this could have been Arizona's ball and an opportunity for a layup. Now watch here. He pulls that ball up strong and forces the foul.
I don't know, man.
What a bad, pass.
Not only a bad pass, but you don't put Kraft in that position to catch the basketball with a defender on his hip and one in front of him.
Well, I think more
very
than once,
fortunate there.
Right. More than once, Aaron Kraft has worn that X on his chest for this team. If I'm Thompson, I got to take a step back and look long.
Kraft is a tough guy now, as we know that he's won the Defensive Player of the Year in the conference. He was also a terrific football player and a two-time first-team All-State quarterback, in addition to being a valedictorian.
Well, that was probably akin to, you know, fumbling the snap and having to go down and get it, right?
He's dug out a lot of them. Lyons. Arizona with no timeouts. 20 for Lyons. Three-point game.
But what it also do with no timeouts, it doesn't allow Thad Mata to put in better free throw shooters. One possession game right here. If you're Sean Miller and the Wildcats, you need one stop
timeout
to somewhat extend your season.
Buckeyes just used their second timeout. They've got one left and they lead by three.
This is my business.
I'm the owner and sole proprietor.
I only have one other employee, Chester.
It's a romantic notion, be the boss, but you are alone.
Well, not technically alone.
I do have a lot of help, actually.
My UPS store.
I have this printed there.
Packing, posters.
I have a mailbox there.
Best thing, they're right down the street.
The owner's a friend.
I got the account.
My team.
Yes!
Careful now.
Start promoting your business with the Small Business Toolkit from the UPS store.
Shot clock at 16, big clock at 43, Buckeyes with the ball and leading by three.
Well, we saw last week in that Iowa State game in a situation somewhat similar to this, with Aaron Kraft holding the basketball up top with that high screen and roll. Iowa State elected to switch and having a bigger defender on Kraft, and he just walked him down and shot down the three. What does Arizona have to do when Kraft's going to have the basketball in up top?
Well, at this point in time, you've got to be able to play some solid defense. Here's the double right here, trying to get the ball out of their hands, but you don't want to foul now. You got, you know, a huge amount of time between the shot clock and the game clock. You make a stop here, you got an opportunity.
Three, Kraft inside. Johnson has the ball. Here comes Arizona, down by three. The try by Lyons.
It's all about taking the best available shot after a terrific defensive stand here on the fast break. Lyons goes hard. Now Ross says he didn't touch him.
Ross has played fantastic all game, but in a situation like that, you got to know time and score. With the Buckeyes up three, you let Lyons go in for the lay-in. Two doesn't hurt you. If Lyons makes this and ties the game, different scenario.
Well, here's what I do. Instinctively, I would have gone after him and not let him get that shot up. It would have been a foul. Not necessarily a hard enough foul for a flagrant one, but it would have been a foul. He had to earn it.
Can Kraft do it again as he did last week versus Iowa State?
We're down to nine. The defense by Nick Johnson. We're down to five, four. Ross for the lead. Boom!
And the officials are going to look at it to see if it's a three. But let me just tell you this. That was an NBA three. I don't know why they are going to the monitors, maybe to look at the time as the ball was going through the net. Maybe they'll award Arizona some more time. But how about the cold-bloodedness of LaQuinton Ross?
And that's the problem with doubling and having a guy like Ross back there. And you're right, the officials want to see the time that's left, to be fair about it. Obviously, he's behind the line. But Thad Mata doesn't like them going to the monitor because it stops play and it gives
absolutely
Sean Miller a timeout.
100% right,
when
man.
He doesn't have one.
With no timeouts left. This is a free timeout for Sean Miller to draw up what we call a home run play. Now we saw Bryce Drew knock this shot down years ago. In fact, our play-by-play, Mr. Astronaut himself, has a commercial about it. So there's similar plays out there.
This is a rule that has obviously begotten unforeseen consequences,
yeah.
Unintended consequences. You just gave Arizona a timeout that they didn't have.
But look, what a shot by Ross. I mean, he's played fantastic. We were just talking about possibly one of the bonehead mistakes of him fouling Lions.
2 seconds right now. Got to get it past the half court.
Yeah, but plenty of time.
Might be the old hook and ladder as you see guys are going to flare out.
2.1.
Right, today, the anniversary of Leighton's shot.
Hill, deflected by Smith. Ohio State's going to the Elite Eight.
We talked about the anniversary of the Lakers shot. One thing that Ohio State recognized, you better put a man on the ball. Made that pass a lot harder.
Tell you what, great effort with Sean Miller not having any timeouts left, really the last 5 or 6 minutes of this ball game, and finding a way to tie the ball game late.
LaQuinton Ross. The sophomore from Jackson, Mississippi, who didn't even play in the tournament a year ago, although he was on this team, scores 17, 14 in the second half, 14 points for the Buckeyes in the final 7 minutes and 59 seconds. For a second consecutive year, Ohio State will play for a regional final. And in the Elite Eight. What a game. Their 11th consecutive win. Ross had 14 of Ohio State's last 17 points. Thomas, the leading scorer, with 20. Ross with 17. Kraft with 13. Let's